हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ सुनील कुमार जादव, वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल। बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स सीरीज आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट, इन विच यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द बेसिक ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। दिस इज फॉर द बिगिनर्स ऑल्सो, दैट यू कैन लर्न ऑल द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स वेरी इजिली। इन इट द फर्स्ट सीरीज ऑफ माइन इज बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स ज्योमेट्री, इन विच यू विल लर्न द डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ द ज्योमेट्री। सो बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स ज्योमेट्री पार्ट वन, लेट अस बिगिन। ज्योमेट्री टर्म यू कैन सी इट इज ज्योमेट्री। दिस टर्म हैज मेनली टू वर्ड्स, जियो एंड मैट्री। इट इज जियो प्लस मैट्री। जियो मीन्स वॉट? जियो मीन्स अर्थ। एंड अनदर वर्ड इट इज मैट्रॉन। मैट्रॉन मीन्स मेजर। सो दिस टर्म ज्योमेट्री कम्स फ्रॉम द मेजर ऑफ द अर्थ। सो दिस इज वॉट द ज्योमेट्री इज। हियर इन दिस वीडियो यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स ऑफ द ज्योमेट्री। विथ वेरी बेसिक लेवल वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस कोर्स। सो इट इज माई हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स दैट हु आर द बिगिनर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स और हु वॉन्ट टू मेक देयर कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स वेरी स्ट्रांग, then see this video up till end and share with your friends also so they can also understand the basic mathematics, especially geometry. So let us begin with basic mathematics geometry part 1. First term of the geometry, that is postulate. What do you understand by postulate? This word you may have heard in geometry, that is postulate. It is also called as axioms in geometry, but actual word of this axiom is different. How do they differ? That also I will discuss. First of all, we will see what is postulate. Postulate is a statement which is accepted true without any proof. That is what we call as a universal truth. So, postulate is a self-evident statement which we accepted to true without any argument or without any proof. This is what it is called as the postulate. I hope you understand. It is universal truth and we have to accept it. This is a statement which is a universal truth which does not require any proof, or we have to accept it true without any proof. That is what we call as the postulate. So postulate is a statement which is accepted true without any proof. So we can call it universal truth. I hope you understand. This is postulate. Axiom is a term used in geometry for the postulate also. But postulate is a term which we are using generally in geometry, while axiom is also the same thing, that it is a universal truth that we can accept it true without any argument or without any proof. But axioms are, it is a general term that we can use it in mathematics also, while postulate is a specific word that we are using only in the geometry. So, postulate is a statement which is accepted true without any proof. Axiom is also such statement which is accepted true without proof. But this is accepted in mathematics, and this term postulate we are using only in the geometry. This is what the difference between the postulate and axiom. In geometry, when we use the word axiom or postulate, it will be considered as the similar. Let us see the second important term, that is theorem. You may have learned about the theorem. You may have proof also. For all those students who are preparing for the competitive exams, those already have listened this word and you have given the proof of the theorem in earlier standard, that is in standard 9th and 10th. So what is the theorem? Statement which needs to prove by logical argument and by use of postulate chain. It means theorem is also a statement which needs to prove, means we need to prove them by the logical argument or whatever the proof, whatever the postulates are there, or the earlier theorem what we have learned. We need to use all those and we need to make it prove. So postulate is a self-evident statement which do not require any proof, while theorem is such a statement which needs to prove by logical argument, or we can say by use of postulate chain. We can do the we can make the chain of the logical argument, and on the basis of those logical argument we can make it true. That statement is true. That is what we call as the theorem. Theorem has mainly three parts. That is, you may have already knowledge about this. For the beginner students, those who are in standard 7 to 9, for them it is new. That is part of theorem. Theorem has mainly three part. That is data, to prove, and proof. What is the meaning of data? Some statement is given. In it, that is what we, what is given is considered as the data. What we want to make it proof, that is what we have taken to be to prove. And proof, say for example, I'll give you one of the example of the part of the theorem. We will take one of the theorem. You know, you may have heard about the Pythagoras theorem. I'll write the statement of the Pythagoras theorem. You know, in right angle triangle, right angle triangle, square of hypotenuse is the sum of the squares of other two sides. This is what the Pythagoras theorem statement. In right angle triangle, square of the hypotenuse is sum of the square of other two sides. If we consider in right angle triangle ABC, we can say in right angle triangle ABC, I can write it. It is a right angle triangle. Where angle B equal to 90. In right angle triangle ABC, where angle B is 90, we can say as per the statement, the square of the hypotenuse in this, if you will draw the figure, you can understand. This is A, B and C, where this B is a right angle. So in that way, this becomes the hypotenuse. So square of the hypotenuse, that is AC square, is equal to sum of the square of both the remaining sides. So that is AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. This is what the statement of the theorem. So what is to be data in this? Data means what? As I said, whatever given. What is given here? Right angle triangle ABC is given. So what would be the data? Data is, we can say data, right angle triangle triangle ABC is given, in which angle B is equal to 90. This is considered to be data. To prove, as I said, to prove what, we have to write it, whatever we want to prove, whatever we want to give the proof, that is what we have to write it under this to prove. So what we have to prove? We have to prove square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of remaining two sides. So it is AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. I hope you understand. In any logical statement, while we are considering as the theorem, we need to prove them. As I said, the statement which needs to prove by logical argument or by use of postulate chain. So in that, this is the statement of the theorem. It is Pythagoras theorem, well-known theorem of the geometry. In right angle triangle, square of the hypotenuse is the sum of the square of other two sides. So if we consider triangle ABC, it is right angle triangle in which angle B is 90. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So what is given here? Triangle ABC with measure angle B equal to 90 given. So right angle triangle ABC with angle B equal to 90 given. and we need to prove AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, I hope. So this is what the theorem has three part. Data means whatever given, we can call it given. To prove means whatever we want to make it proof, that is we consider, we will write it under the proof, and ultimately with the logical argument we have to prove. So data to prove, and ultimately the stage proof will come in which we will prove it with the help of the figure. So these are the things that is related to theorem. Let us go for the next term, that is defined term. What is the meaning of defined term? You know, in mathematics we are normally giving the definition of something. So that what we called all those terms which has the definition, they are called as the defined term. And certain terms which do not have any definition are considered as the undefined term. Remember this, it is a very important question in the geometry. Which are the terms which are undefined terms in the geometry? This is most important question for the geometry. Remember it always. That is point, line, plane and space. These are the four terms in geometry which are considered undefined terms in the geometry. Rather than these four terms, any other terms we can define in the geometry. Remember this very well. Point, we cannot define. You know, point is expressed by the dot, and we cannot define this dot. Another thing, line. Line is also cannot define. It is going up to infinity in both the directions, so it is also considered as the undefined term. Another one is a plane. What is the meaning of plane? Plane is not that one, aeroplane. Plane means what? This is a paper. Consider this is a paper, and this paper has the infinite boundary for all the side. This side is extended, this side and this side, all the sides are extended up to infinity, then it is considered as the plane. So we cannot define the plane. And space. What is space? Space means everything around us is considered as the space. So we cannot give any specific definition to the space also. So remember that undefined terms. There are four terms in the geometry which are considered as the undefined term. Number one, it is point. Number two, line. Number three, plane. And number four, space. So this is all about undefined term. Rather than these four terms in the geometry, point, line, plane and space, all the other terms are considered as the defined term. So this is very basic fundamental things. In part one, we have seen what is postulate or axiom. Then we saw what is theorem. What is defined term and what is undefined term? Which are the undefined terms in the geometry? That we saw in part 1. In next part, we will see furthermore about the basic mathematics geometry part 2. So, I hope in this you have understood about postulate, theorem, undefined terms and defined terms. As well as what are the terms in geometry which are considered as the undefined term. Theorem has mainly three part, data to prove and proof, that also we saw in this video. I hope you understand it very clearly. If you really understand it, then click on the like button so I can understand that you have understood this concept very well. And share with your friends so they can also understand this concept very easily. See you in part 2 of Basic Mathematics Geometry 2. Thank you so much.